spotted lanternflies. It's an invasive species, which causes a lot of economic damage, especially in the northeastern states. Researchers are looking into stopping these beautiful nuisance creatures, and they need our help.
Let's have a look at the five different ways we can catch and kill the lanternflies.
First one is a simple soap solution method. We have been using this mainly in our vegetable garden. It may fly off as you spray, but eventually it will die. Let's have a look at the second method.
One of the traps that I have set up here is a sticky tape with fiberglass mesh. And for one, this barrier really helps protect wildlife like birds, bats, and our important pollinator insects from getting stuck on it. On top of that, it also traps the adult lanternflies really well. If they're pretty strong insects, so they might try to hop off, but this mesh barrier pushes them right back in. It's very easy to get set up, and it's quite inexpensive. This mesh roll can be only $10, $15. And basically, you just create cleats at the top, all around the top, and put it pretty flat to the tree, and then it's very easy to change out. You just have to lift up the mesh, change out the tape, and then put it right back down.
Third one is a circle trap. Let's see how we can put this on. This one probably the most environment friendly trap, because there are no glue or sticky tapes are involved. Sticky tapes are really good to catch lanternflies, but it can also kill a lot of the native bugs and spiders. There is only one opening to this trap. Once the lanternfly started to follow the path, it will end up in the bag. Once it ended up in the bag, that'll be the end of it. Fourth one, probably the most time-consuming method, but it is a very important one which can help to break the life cycle of this bug. In this method, the eggs of the lanternfly is being scraped into a plastic bag with alcohol in it. It will kill the larvae and the eggs immediately. And to the last method. If you see one, just squish it. Why not involve the kids too for some extra fun?
The materials that I've used to make all of these traps are in the description. If you like this video, please hit the like and subscribe button.
Very similar to the coronavirus, reducing the spread is the key. Hopefully, that will give enough time for the researchers to find a permanent natural solution to this mess.